I don't know of anything much more fulfilling than to see a possibility or an opportunity when nobody else sees it, maybe, or see a piece of it that's already existent and say, wow, I could do that. And it's not always about how good you are, or how talented you are. You have to work 10 times as hard to cut through some of this. When I see things getting tough, or when I see things that seem insurmountable to other people, I know we just have to stay the course, we have to stay focused, and we keep putting one foot in front of the other. The key is to keep moving. When we lost our home and we had to go live with my grandparents, I understood that these are just material things, that doesn't define you. It doesn't make you. So when you get these challenges, when you have these things that come up in your life, continue to move forward. Now, how do you get to that place where you come back and move forward and that you become very intentional about it? I just did one of our footnotes that's sort of a daily motivational inspirational thing about baby steps. Mm. Baby steps. Become intentional about what it is that you're going to do. Nobody in your family may have done that. Nobody in your community, your city, your country may have done that. But if that's what's been put here for you, take it in baby steps. Begin to see how that you're going to move forward. It's exactly what I did once I came and I understood my purpose and I understood what it is that I was supposed to be doing. I sat down and created a plan as to how I was going to go about deploying that. And I think that's what you really have to do. And take it in baby steps. Don't try to do the whole thing at once. Sit it down, look at it, break it down, rebuild it, put it back together, and then assign time frames to everything that you want to accomplish and break it down in phases and then focus everything you have on that phase. We only know what we know right now about what we want to do, right? I mean, there could be things out there that will be so much more awesome, but we don't know what we don't know.
Right.
And to the best of our ability, what we can say is, here's where I am right now. I can put a waypoint right there. I can mark that. And I know that I want to do X. And this is that thing. So if I'm going to step back, now what I've got to do is go to work. I've got to study every single bit of that and understand every iteration. I think every successful person always looks at other successful people, especially in their field or a field they're endeavoring to get into. Why fix it if it's not broke? You just have to find your piece of it that you bring to make it you. But if they're doing it and they're doing it incredibly well, sit back and look at it and find all the ways that you can take that great model, fix it where you feel like it needs to be fixed, make it you, and then can you add to it? Can you put something on top of it? And then you take that and really, that's when you start to really do the work and sit down and study each piece of it. And then you assign the time frames. I think the time frames, the timelines are the critical piece to it, because that's where so many people go from just having a hobby or a dream. And I'm sure many people understand that dreams are tough, because without a time frame, a timeline, they may just stay dreams. When you assign a time frame and a plan of action to it, it can become a goal, and then it can become attainable. And I think that's what you have to do, is makes it very present then. You have your work cut out for you, you know what you need to do, and now it's just about doing it. Just whatever you do, don't stop. Because more than 99% assuredness, nobody's gonna know it was a screw up unless you stop. If you keep moving, everybody's gonna think that's just, you know, own it. If you were supposed to go right and you go left, then the minute that you realize, oh my God, I just went left, what am I going to do? Go to the crowd and start going, you know, right, dancing to the crowd or do. They're never going to know that it was a mess up. So yes, you have to improvise, you have to adapt, you have to overcome, you have to be like water. The great Bruce Lee saying that, you know, you have to be able to conform yourself to those situations so that you ever don't do yourself a disservice by not growing and not becoming better. You have to be able to be malleable. And I think that's the greatest thing about being shaped and having been to that place. You know, it may cause you to go through some growing pains, but that's awesome. And at first, when you go through that, you're just, oh my God, it hurts. I don't want to be here. It hurts. And complain, complain, complain. But if you start to look at it, once you've got through it a couple times, you're like, oh, here we go. This is probably going to be pretty good. Oh, yeah. oh, but this is going to be awesome. Like, I know, wow, man, this really hurts. So if it's really hurting, I know it's really going to be good on the other side of it. And you just see yourself grow and you grow and you grow and you grow. And
what does it mean to you? You've got a really powerful saying, we are the people we've been waiting for.
Right.
What does that mean? What do you hope people do with that?
I think that everything that has been done before us is a part of us. And so it's equally as important that we do everything that we possibly can with our life for everything that they did for us before we were even born. And I think that makes it even more powerful when you think of, we can't depend on other people. That's sort of been my through line, is I've never understood how you can be independently codependent. You either can be independent and stand on your own two feet and know who you are and what you're here for, and in the tough times, when everything is pulling you to do something, you know, that maybe just go with the flow, that's the moment you have to be the flow. And it may run in the opposite direction of the current that's asking you to jump in. You have to lead. You have to be willing to lead. And if you're not, nobody will follow that. And in the moments where it's most stressful, if you don't know where you're headed, if you don't know what you're supposed to be doing, nobody else will either. And you have to be able to stay that course and be willing to do what you need to do. So if, you know, a couple, their family can go out and garner enough support to be able to execute and deploy and logistically do this whole effort, what is our bigger excuse to not do this? If a few people can make this happen, collectively, what could we do? And it was to really say that as well. And in order to say that, you have to be willing to do more. You have to be willing to take a stand and make a difference, almost on an epic scale, just sometimes to get people's attention.
You talk a lot about self-belief. How can people cultivate that?
If you don't love you, you can't love anybody else. If you don't appreciate you, it's impossible to appreciate anybody. If you don't respect yourself, it's impossible to respect somebody else.
But how do you think about failure? What do you teach your kids about failure? Do you see it as a teaching mechanism, something to be afraid of? Like, how do you conceptualize of that in your life?
Failures are our greatest teachers. I don't think anybody that's ever endeavored to ever do anything didn't fail at some point in some aspect of what they were trying to do. We learn from it and we move forward. We're people and we feel how people feel, meaning it hurts when people say bad things about us. It doesn't feel good when people don't believe in you. My dad always told me, if something ever doesn't go the way that you've planned and you find yourself in that situation, don't panic. The most important thing you can do is stay calm, stay present. And I think that presence of mind and that being able to be calm, that you've laid a plan out, you've done what you've done that got you to this point. If something comes up that you didn't expect or that you didn't know was going to come, your plan's not bad. It got you to where you are. Right now, you have to deal with what's in front of you. That doesn't mean run away. It doesn't mean stop and don't do anything. It means deal with it. Deal with what's in front of you. Move through it, move around it, move over it, move under it, but keep moving forward. Rectify the situation, regroup, and go. So there's always going to be hard times. And you just have to have belief in that where you are is where you're supposed to be. And by moving forward, the strength of your faith will unleash the power of the Creator in your life. So being aware of whatever it is that you're going to get into or whatever is passionate about you. But I think that you really have to understand that if it's your dream and that you're moving forward to accomplish your dream, don't let anyone ever take that from you. Don't let anyone kill your passion about what it is that you feel innately is what you're supposed to do, what your journey is. That's yours. That's almost been ordained to you, specifically, uniquely, that you may be the one person that's able to move that forward. Don't let anybody rob you of that. And it's gonna happen. People are going to doubt you. People are going to, and as you had mentioned, you know, there's going to be people that just don't see it. They just don't get it. And it sucks. I mean, it's hard to maintain that excitement. I think the other thing right there in that window is, you know, absolutely be about it if you expect other people to be about it. If you want people to be 100% excited, understand you got to be 150% excited about it. Nobody is ever going to be more excited about what you're doing than you. So you better be on fire about it. If you walk in with your head down or you don't feel that this is something that you really, at the core of your being, believe in, then you're not ready to walk in there yet. Don't go until you know it better than no one else, that you know it better than anybody else on this earth. That's vital. You have to know what you're doing. You have to know every bit of it to the best of your ability so that you can talk about it. Because the minute they see you flinch, the minute that they see you not know, or you start to make it up as you go, I think that's where people start to lose confidence in who you are, what you're about, what you're talking about. You have to be able to walk in, and I think that all comes with knowing your service, your product, what it is that you're doing, your story better than anybody else could ever tell it, and being on fire about it. And you don't have to, if it's really your passion, it's really that, it's just gonna come out of you. But a lot of people maybe have to work on that skill more than other people, right? And I think that, you know, get in the mirror, get your wife, get your uncle, get anybody that'll let you listen, that'll let you talk to them and listen, and maybe help tell you, hey, look, I didn't really believe that too much. You know, maybe, well, where did you stop believing me? What did I not communicate on? And just go through the iterations, do the work, practice whatever it is that you've got that you want to communicate to folks. And I think that's communication. I think back about what my dad said, and I said it earlier, be able to speak, be able to know what you're trying to say. And if you can communicate to people, if you can speak and talk about your idea, you know, that's the key to it all. You've got to be able to express, and I think there's so many things people will find as they begin that journey that they didn't even know they had. But you got to take one step, and I think that's where people fail, is they don't start.